It all starts with a dead girl. Ever since I was little, I've had this dream. It's the end of summer. A girl is running through the woods. The moon, the scent of pines. And then the gunshot. It always felt so real. The blood on my cheek, the cold sweat running down my skin. I'd managed to convince myself it really happened, this scar of a memory. A part of me I could never fully understand. Well, that wasn't the only part. No wonder people used to think I was strange. If they only knew. That day when the phone rang, it was the hardest day of my life. The day I went home to say goodbye to my father. Dress him up for his last journey. Put him in a suit, fix his tie. Simple. Just the things he did every day. But looking through his stuff wasn't easy. I needed a moment to pull myself together. I was almost ready. I just had to find his special tie clip.
Yeah. Nice to see you too. Jack's room. It's like he never... Damn it.
Jack was a humble, religious man. He ran a funeral home, and I'd help out whenever I could. It felt good to be useful. I used to think I'd never fit in, but Jack, He didn't mind my weirdness. He kept telling me I was special.
Keep hissing at me.
Who do you think's gonna feed you now? Weird to be back in my old room. So many memories. My oldest family heirloom. As a kid, I'd usually say something like, "Pretty sick, huh?" I used to get a lot of these. To me, they were like trophies. Badges of honor for doing the right thing. Jack wasn't too amused, but he did his best to cover for me. I kind of feel bad for making him go through all that. Interesting. Right. The tie clip. Pull yourself together, Marianne. Looks nourishing. Here you go. What's your face? Glad to see you're still kicking around. I believe it's all still here. Oh, Jack. I guess I forgot about this one. I can do it now. Too soon. It needs to stay in longer. last photo I took of you, Jack.
Shit.
Come on, Jack. Where'd you put it?
Okay.
Let's do this the other way. There you are. Okay, I think that's it. Jack's waiting downstairs. Time to say goodbye. We lived upstairs from Jack's funeral home. It wasn't as weird as it sounds. Besides, if it wasn't for that, I may never have learned to use my powers. Jack taught me to accept my condition. Of all my foster parents, he was the only one who saw it as a gift and not a curse. Jack's in the prep room. Huh, weird. I don't remember locking it. The key should be in the office. Here it is. Not sure if I'm ready for this. Hey, Jack. Got your special clip? No. Where's your tie? Snazzy. You wouldn't have it any other way. I didn't expect this to be easy. I guess I didn't know what to expect. When things get personal, it just burns you from the inside out. There. I guess you're ready. But am I? Can't you people read? The sign says closed. You felt it too, huh? And then it happened, as it did so many times before, just when I thought my day couldn't get any worse.
Where is that darn notebook? gonna be late. I need to find that. Marianne? Marianne, are you crying, my child?
It's fine, Jack.
Now, you didn't happen to see my notebook, did you, darling? My memory's a bit fuzzy. So much for aging gracefully, eh?
Where is that? Listen, Jack. You should probably get some rest. Forget the notebook.
Oh, no, no. I've got so much work, my dear.
It's okay, Jack.
I can't just...
Let it go. It's not important.
You are crying. What's wrong, dear? Why is it so cold in here? Where is that?
It's okay, Jack. It's okay.
My sweet little Marianne. What would I ever do without you?
Jack. Don't worry about it. It's time to get some rest.
Oh, Marianne.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm worried about the surgery. When I'm at the hospital, are you sure you're going to be all right?
Yes, Jack. It's going to be fine.
You know, I promised myself once... I would never let anything happen to you. Not while I'm around.
I'll be fine. I promise.
No risky stuff, then. Huh? Right?
All right, Jack. Now, get some rest.
I need... Yes. Be good, Marianne. I love you, my child. I've loved you since the moment you walked into my life. Remember that. Always.
Most people would give anything to have that opportunity. To say all the things that were left unsaid. But it didn't make things any easier. I could help 1,000 souls cross over, but when it came to Jack, it still hurt like hell.
I love you too, Daddy.
I used to think everyone saw the world the way I did. Divided. Torn between two realities. But... no. I was the only one. Or so I thought.
We're closed. There's another funeral home across town. I can give you the number.
Marianne.
Who is this?
You don't know me, Marianne. But I know you.
Look. If this is a joke...
You'd need to listen to me, Marianne.
Okay, I'm hanging up.
I know what you are.
What? Who is this?
My name is Thomas. I need your help.
Listen, if that's all you've got, I'm...
No, there's more. I can give you the answers you've been looking for your whole life. But I need you to trust me.
Trust you? I don't even know you.
It all starts with a dead girl.
What did you say?
The Nemo Resort. Find me there. Please. The light, it's almost gone. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there. You're the only one who can stop it. You're my only chance.
Hello? Hello? Shit. And off I went, on nothing but a hunch. A call from a complete stranger. But I'd learned to trust my instincts, and there was something about this guy, his voice. I felt like I should know him. Either way, he sure seemed to know me. The NVIDIA Workers Resort. Right off the bat, I could feel there was something off about that place. Anyone home? I guess not. You want to keep me out, Neva? They're gonna have to do better than that. Not a whole lot of people knew about Neva. It used to be a government-owned vacation resort. Until one day it just stopped. And so an urban legend was born. The Neva Massacre. The details were always fuzzy. Crazed workers, ancient curses. You know, the usual. Hello. What's this? Like an old fort. Might be my way in. Something happened here. Split would come and go. If a place had a story to tell, well, I guess I was there to listen. Thank you. Yeah, not getting through here. Not with the power out. When you exist in two realities, you're affected by either. I'd learned that the hard way. The place felt old and soaked in misery. Figures, I guess. 1,000 years of history doesn't just happen. It's paid for. But even in the deepest darkness, light can linger. Lonely, fragile, waiting for someone to embrace it. As I absorbed the energy, I wondered who it was that left it behind. A dying soldier whispering the name of his beloved? Or maybe just glad to be done with this world? In any case, I figured I could use it. Energy's energy, right?
Oh, so that worked. Good for you, Marianne.
These powers of mine, as much of a pain in the ass as they were, So there I was, existing in two worlds, but never really living in either. you, Neva? The aura in that place. I've seen others like it, but never this intense. It was like a landfill of memories, emotions, and none of them good.
Definitely something. Trust me, you made the right call sending me. Yes. It's only a matter of time.
Even the objects here had auras. When I touched them, I could sense their stories. Words, images, feelings left behind.
Hello? Anybody in there?
Locked. Obviously. There's gotta be another way. Ah. I think there's a broken window up there. If only I could reach it. Shit, the handle's missing. Maybe I could replace it with something. Hey, old timer. Now, what's a fine machine like you doing in a place like this? Doubling as a spare bedroom, apparently. Hope you don't mind if I... Not much here. Although, this could come in handy. Ow! Shit! So began the great dumpster heist of 1999. I'm starting to get tired of your shit, Neva. You better be worth it. To find this Thomas guy and get the hell out of here.
Hello? Anyone? Thomas? You there? Hello? Thomas?
Easy, Marianne. It's just a good old-fashioned haunted hotel. Calm your ass down and answer the bell. Startled me.
I did, didn't I? You look real scared. I'm sadness.
Marianne. Sadness. Is that your name? I mean, you seem pretty cheerful to me.
Well, it's what I remember. My friends used to call me by a different name. But I don't remember what it was.
Your friends?
Oh, yeah. I used to have a lot of friends here. But they're all gone now.
Did something happen to them?
I don't really want to talk about it.
That's okay. So, do you live here? All by yourself?
You wouldn't believe how boring it gets sometimes.
I can imagine. This place must have been...
Oh, yes. So busy. People coming and going all the time. Always someone to play with.
Must have been nice.
It was. Not anymore.
So, tell me, what happened?
I remember. People stopped coming. Only a few of them stayed. But they became very sad. Very angry. They might hurt you.
Thanks. But I can take care of myself. Hey, I was wondering, have you seen...
Marianne?
Yes?
Would you play with me? Just for a little while. It's been so long since I played with anyone.
Oh, okay, okay. But I need your help first.
Yes. Yes! Anything, Marianne!
For a man. Thomas. Do you know him?
Let me think. I've heard that name before. Somewhere.
Take your time.
Oh, yeah. The second floor. We can look there. Come on. Hurry,
Marianne. Wait. I can't go that way. Damn. I need to get up there somehow. Hey, an elevator. We'll see if it works. I wished I knew her real name. Shit! Okay, Marianne, just take a deep breath and... let go. There. A fuse box. Need some energy to spark it up. Out-of-body experience. It's like taking a plunge into nothingness. Stay under for too long and it just pulls you in. Thank you. where did she go? What is that?
Sadness?
Okay. Not getting through here. Shit. I didn't even know I could do that.
Yes. I'm working on it. Yes, I know. Yes. I understand. Just give me some time. A few days. You'll get what you want.
Ugh. That voice. I don't know why, but it gives me shivers. Looks like the only way. Great. What's that? This room. It feels cold. Memories of grief, loneliness. Shit, there are thousands of them. I'm gonna need more energy to get through. The spark's too weak to absorb. It's like it's missing something. Thank you. spark's too weak to absorb. It's like it's missing something. Some objects soak up moments from the past. Just squeeze in the right spot and let it pour out.
Ah, sunflower, weary of time. For my favorite nurse.
Oh, Mr. Tarkovsky, you shouldn't have.
Please, it's the least I can do for all the good work you do around here.
Huh. An actual happy memory. So there's more to this place.
Ah, sunflower, weary.
Oh, me.
An old prescription. I know these drugs all too well. Disturbingly satisfying.
You... I know you're there. Wish I had the strength to cut you out. You don't deserve to exist. You're nothing!
There have been times when I thought about ending it all. But I was too afraid that a part of me would go on, trapped on the other side. Forever. This could be useful. The light of a memory strong enough to defy this place. moths to its white. Is that skin? If only I had something sharp. Manager, huh?
Marianne!
Oh, Sadness. We gotta stop meeting like this.
I told you to follow me!
Take it easy, Sad. This place is huge. Easy to get lost.
Just stick with me.
Okay. I'll stick like a tick.
You're funny.
This Thomas Rekovich.
What?
All right. Listen, hun. You said you remembered someone named Thomas. Was it Thomas Rekovich? Was he the manager here?
I guess.
You think he stuck around?
I'm not sure. There was an old man here, very recently, I think. Oh.
And you think it was Thomas?
Oh, I don't know. Old men all look the same, all wrinkly and old. Blah.
Hey, that's not very nice. Well, if he's still around, I've got an infestation to report.
Marianne! I feel... Oh, I don't think we should be here.
It's okay, Sadness. Look, there's no one... here. Sadness? It all hit me as soon as I entered the room. Anguish. Fear. Longing. What the hell happened here? It still works. Someone's been using it. Small to fit a door. My senses jolted as I touched the phone. I could tell it had been used recently to call me. Burn marks, broken glass, and is that salt? Someone jotted this down recently. Grand opening, I assume. Hey, is that the first secretary? They must have had some big plans for this place. I could instantly tell there was more to that clock than met the eye. There we go. That's as far as it goes. There. An imprint. Is that... Thomas? As I moved the clock hand, I realized it was a junction between realities. It's rare, but I'd seen it before.
No. Don't do it. I can't. We... must. No. Don't do it. I can't. We... feel something's wrong. It's coming.
Looks like a passage.
Shit. I thought I had it this time. It's taking too long. What am I missing?
Someone tried real hard to keep this place a secret. Wonder what's in here on the other side.
Gotta check the wiring. I'd hate to get stuck in there.
A spirit well. I could absorb some of that energy. See if it worked. Old invoices. Thank you.
I'll never get used to this. I could sense something stirring behind that symbol, like a gust of wind moving a curtain. Hope he's not using it as a textbook. Nope. Doesn't work. Ugh. Okay. I know how this works. I need three liquids to develop the photo. Looks like there's a tray missing. Missed my window. Now it's overexposed. That's one. Two more to go. Okay, that's all of them. This should come in handy. Shit, I messed it up. Need to dip it in the right order. was there. Hello? Are you all right?
Don't look at me! Don't go! It all ends in me.
Don't go!
Oh, God.
Don't leave me here. Alone!
Naked!
Let me draw you off.
Oh, God! No!
Don't worry. It's just not. It all ends in me.
Oh, God.
Let me try you on.
Oh, God. No!